Good afternoon to everyone. Welcome to this new session of the CIMNE Coffee Talks. I have to say that a sort of tradition has been established in the last years in which Eugenio, which is a full professor at the Universitat Politécnica de Catalunya and director of CIMNE, explains a bit of the history of CIMNE, how we got here and what is ahead of us. No? Just a summary, Eugenio's research is focused on the development of numerical methods to solve problems in the field of strength of material, analysis of structures, fluid dynamics, heat transmission, and couple problems between structure and fluids. No? Eugenio, it's a pleasure to have you here today at the Cafés of CIMNE, and without any comments, I'll give you the floor. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Alejandro. I'm going to share my presentation. Just let me know, Alejandro, when you can see it.
Now you're presenting. Yes.
Can you see the presentation?
Yes, perfectly.
Yes.
Well, thank you very much, Alejandro. Thank you for accepting my proposal, which was motivated by the fact that we have incorporated into CIMNE quite a number of people in the last 2 years, you will see later. And in the interviews, I noticed that they knew very little about us, you know, or at most they knew or they know what they saw in the webpage. So I thought, okay, we, as you said, we have done this exercise of looking back over the years in the past. In fact, this is the third time that I do this exercise. And of course, for those of you who attended the previous lecture, everything which you heard is still true. I mean, I have not modified the past. And I hope I'm not going to repeat entirely what I have said previously, but unfortunately, I will have to really comment on things that some of you might have already heard. Okay, I insist on my personal view, and this will allow me to, be the only one to blame for mistakes, inconsistencies, and most of all for many people who will be lacking, of course, in the photograph or even to be mentioned. You know, this is an impossible task, so I already apologize in advance. And 34 years is a strange number. This anticipates the 35th anniversary of CIMNE, but it's also anticipating my retirement from university, which is coming close, close to that date. So I have thought, okay, altogether, why not gaining time ahead and introducing this perspective view today, and this will remain as a kind of heritage for future similar talks in the future. So I will follow the trend that I use in previous lectures, and I will talk. I will go back a few years before the creation of CIMNE, and everything that I'm going to say has to be framed within the field of engineering, you know. CIMNE is competing or is included in a cluster of research centers, many of them dealing with high science, like biology or medicine or high physics, but we are just engineers who are motivated by contributing to science, applied science and engineering from our own perspective. In that sense, everything goes back to a civil engineering organization, which was the Civil Engineering Department at the University College of Swansea. And this is September 1975. Each of you can think, where were you in September 1975? Well, I was actually just finished my degree of civil engineering. This is, I promise, this is myself, yes. Through some contacts I had, I was introduced, I was lucky to get into the the civil engineering department at Swansea University in Wales. As many of our students here, I went there just to do an MSc, a Master of Science, for 1 year. But what started in 1 year actually went on much longer in the future. Swansea is a beautiful place, it's a beautiful spot, surrounded by these long beaches, which remind to the Irish beaches in Ireland and vice versa. I encourage you to go and visit Swansea. Many of you have done it. We have many contacts, many friends who are now members of the staff at the civil engineering and other departments in Swansea. And I was lucky I met this person, Professor Sienkiewicz, to whom I will refer during this presentation, because he gave me the opportunity to continue my master studies into the PhD. Okay, this was how he was looking. Well, he was about probably about my age in those days. A few years later, in December 78, I finished my PhD. And then I was lucky that Professor Sienkiewicz was invited to give a number of lectures in Spain, and I joined him in that trip. And in fact, we were both in the program of a conference which was held in Tarrasa. Yes, Tarrasa was holding this conference on, it was called Applied Numerical Modeling, and I had a lecture there on, you see, isoparametric shell elements. So this was already something in those days. And there, when I came to Barcelona, I met the staff here at the School of Civil Engineering. The school had just started in 1974, and they were recruiting people. I was lucky that they were recruiting people from all over the world. Many of them had been recruited from the US, and I was offered a job. And I joined the School of Civil Engineering in fact, it was February 14th, 1979, two months later after this Tarrasa course. And this is how the school would look in those days. In fact, this is where the rector house is now. Those premises were the School of Civil Engineering, the whole park. It was actually our home for many years, almost 20 years. We were there until the rector took over. The school was founded by this person. It's called, still is alive, is José Antonio Torroja Cabanillas. He is very famous because he's the son of one of the most famous structural engineers in Spain in the 20th century, Eduardo Torroja. And he also became famous because he was the father of a famous singer, Ana Torroja. So he always said that he always used to say that he never was famous for himself, you know. But in fact, he is very well known. He is a professor on concrete analysis, and he was the founder and first director of the School of Civil Engineering, and he actually hired me. And when I arrived, the school was directed by Professor Eduardo Alonso. Oh, excuse me. You can see him there, together with the rector at UPC at those days. This Gabriel Ferrate was rector of UPC for about 20 years. He was a very good rector. Okay. And he managed to actually change the constitution of the university a few times. So he actually was a kind of perpetual rector. And with him, actually, the school made much progress. In fact, I took over the directorship of the school after Eduardo Alonso. And this is the second important person here, the one on the left, I mean. The one on the right, he was President Pujol, also very relevant. And president of Catalonia for 20 years as well. But Professor Manuel Castelero, in fact, he was the person who hired me. Actually, he was in charge of recruiting new staff at the school. And this is in one of the corridors of the school in one of the events. And of course, I will refer to Professor Castelero, who has recently passed away, as some of you might know. Well, during those days, the school was using the facilities in the garden, and this is where we were placing our equipment. And of course, I was in charge of the lecturing structural analysis. And through José Antonio Torroja, we actually imported some testing material from Switzerland. And here I am with Professor Oliver and Professor Suarez. You might not recognize them. And this, the lady, is Professor Elena Blanco, who retired from the school a few years back. And we also actually were combining our theoretical work with some experimental work and also some field work. So we actually will try to be engineers, but never forgetting our vocation for science. In those days, the school was a kind of a family organization. We used to get together and celebrate everything during those days. And soon we incorporated into these gatherings our colleagues from Swansea. You can see Professor Sienkiewicz, one of these meetings, Professor Ernie Hinton, and dinners all the time with this, with any every occasion that we could celebrate with friends. And in fact, we were using the garden as a kind of a reunion place in the weekends, and this became a tradition years later. But you see, we took advantage of this link with Swansea to have the first joint event in the same year. It was December 79. We had a course on finite element methods in engineering. This was just an ordinary course. In fact, we designed the announcement. You can see it's a very basic course. But it was very successful. We attracted some like 80 participants. And then we saw that this was there was a need and there was a high interest in Spain for this type of field, the knowledge of the finite element method. And for 10 consecutive years, we repeated the course. So every Christmas, and you can see here the announcement for 1980, and then the course had two parts, basic and advanced. So together with our colleagues from Swansea, we repeated the course. Eh? And you can see the registration of the course was in one of the rooms of the school. And this was what the course was taught. This is the audience in one of the courses. Some of these, you know, they came from all over the place. The rooms were always full. This was Professor Owen. And we were using some books which have been the Bible for those of us who have learned finite elements in those days. This was a book about the programming finite elements in Fortran. The book is from 1977. This is another basic book about basic knowledge on finite element methods. And this is the first book on finite elements in plasticity, also from 1980. Both Professor Hinton and Professor Owen, both lecturing at this course for 10 years, they were the authors of these books. And you can see some of the courses. This is 1981. And then the courses became a kind of part of the specialty of the School of Civil Engineering. And you can see more announcements of the courses. But then we decided, why not having a first Congress in the field? So in 1982, I mean, 3 years after the first course, we organized the first symposium of finite element methods in engineering, here in Barcelona, okay? And it was very, very successful. We had about 200 people. The Congress was organized in the chapel of the school. You will see it in a minute. And this is the book that was edited by Professor Castellero, Professor Alonso, and myself. And then 2 years later, we decided to go international. They said, why don't we have an international course together with our colleagues from Swansea? And then this was a joint event, Swansea-Barcelona, held in Barcelona. These are our colleagues. This is Professor Hinton, Professor Owen. You can see them there. Let's see if I can have one of these pointers. You can see Professor Owen, you will recognize, and Professor Hughes here, looking very young and very smart those days already. Well, the course, as I said, was taught in the chapel. This is where the supercomputer is. So let's say, maybe we could call ourselves superhumans. We were there before the supercomputer. This is how the chapel will look. It was full of people. They would not mind the inconvenience of the chapel, or even the basic multimedia tools that we will use to project. You see, this is how the international community was happy to join a conference in those days. Well, 1 year later, we created a journal, which is running since those days. So this journal has from 85 to now, it's almost 39, 38 to 32 years, 37 years. And this is UPC Journal. And 1 year later, we had the second course on second symposium on application of numerical methods. This is 86. And then what happened is there was a turning point. Otherwise, we would have followed without CIMNE. The turning point is that we met this gentleman. And this gentleman is Dr. Geoffrey Hollister, again, a civil engineer and a co-author with Professor Sienkiewicz on a book on stress analysis. He was a former postdoc from Swansea, and he was appointed one of the directors in UNESCO. And then he wanted to promote civil engineering and computational methods in the world, and he created this network of centers for computer applications, okay? International Network of Centers for Computer Applications. And then we saw the opportunity and said, well, if there is a network of centers, why don't we have a center? And then we proposed to create a center for numerical methods that will become a member of this network. And in fact, it became the secretariat of the network while it lasted, because it failed some years back. Okay, but this was the motivation. So, and then it was, well, relatively easy, let's call it, to convince the government, local government, to in with the university and create in cooperation with UNESCO, because it was UNESCO who explained the government the interest of the field and then the interest to create a center that will specialize in numerical methods in engineering, whatever it was, whatever it meant for the president of the government and or even for the rector. But our rector was very clever. He was a man from robotics. He knew what we were talking about. And this is the signature of the agreement between the government, the university represented here by the rector, and UNESCO at the government palace. This is at the government palace. And of course, to round up the event, we gave an honorary doctorate in the same day to the director general of EMBO. And you see here the chapel again. I always think that this is a nice, it was a nice use of the chapel for these honorary degrees. We had a few of them over the years. And this is how CIMNE started. You can see here Manuel Castellero, you can see here Geoffrey Hollister. And this is our first leaflet. And this is, in fact, it was just produced for the event. It was produced in March 87. And we were already pushing from CIMNE activities, but of course using the staff of the School of Civil Engineering. And and 1 month after CIMNE was created, 1 month after CIMNE started, we had the conference again, the first conference on plasticity. So the conference on computational plasticity, which the next one will be held in next September, goes with CIMNE in terms of when it started. You see, this is the first course on plasticity and the first conference, both from April 87, think that CIMNE was created a few weeks before that date. This is during the COMPLAS, Professor Owen, Professor Hinton, they already had been in Barcelona. They enjoy Barcelona a lot. And COMPLAS became, through this series of conference and the previous one, which we had in 84, famous all over the world because of the quality of the social, the quality of the scientific program, and also the quality of the social program. It was becoming very, very popular. But those days were also where another idea started, and this is not so well known. This is how the UNESCO chair on numerical methods in engineering started. And this was again an idea of Geoffrey Hollister, who read this book. This is a book, a humorous book, about a number of professors in linguistics who heard of a UNESCO chair by which they wouldn't have to lecture and they could travel all over the world, sponsored by this UNESCO chair. This is the story in the book. And Professor Hollister said, oh, this is a fantastic idea. And he created the concept of UNESCO chair. And why not? He created and we appointed the first UNESCO professor, Professor Sienkiewicz, who was part of the numerical methods gang in Barcelona in those days. And this is how we have this recognition of being the first UNESCO chair. It is a chair at the university. And of course, now there are about 400 chairs, UNESCO chairs in the world. The UNESCO just give the title, UNESCO give the diploma, and the funding comes from a third party organization. But this is how this started. Okay. And now we have, after the death of Professor Sienkiewicz, we have here Professor Jacques Periot, whom you might, some of you might know, and he is the current UNESCO professor. Professor Jacques Periot, very active member of our community, and he will be turning 80 this year. He is still very actively working with CIMNE. Time goes on, went on, conferences, COMPLAS went on. Now I think COMPLAS is now in the 16th or 17th edition. Other conferences were organized. We were very motivated by education those days. So we had this conference on computers, the use of computers for education. In 89, after 2 years after CIMNE started, we pushed forward the Spanish Association for Numerical Methods in Engineering. It was created in Madrid. But the secretariat is hosted here in Barcelona since that those days, and it's now the 32nd anniversary of CIMNE. And CIMNE organized many conferences, something like 15 conferences. This was the first one in Gran Canaria in 1990, the second one in Coruña, and so on. Over the years, we organized a number of conferences. And also I bring this here because from the very beginning we were conscious of the importance of a good link with UPC. CIMNE had been born from the School of Civil Engineering. CIMNE was starting to have their own its own personality, but we always were very much aware, and I would say very much loyal to UPC as one of the members of what is called the crown of UPC. Okay, you can see the crown of UPC and all these entities. Which is different from CIMNE, of course, some of them related to photonics, biomechanics, etc., form part of this crown, and CIMNE is proudly member of this crown of organizations. And this is relevant to say, because even today, this is even more important, where many of our CIMNE researchers are members of UPC staff. And we have created this channel, communication channel, between both organizations, I think for the benefit of both parties. Well, 1992 was a very special year. You might recall it was the Olympics in Barcelona, and of course we had our conference. Yeah? This was a conference, and this was already in the premises of the new School of Civil Engineering. You see, this is a North Campus. I think this was the first event that was held in campus, and this followed the trend of the previous conferences. We had a second conference on parallel computing. You see, we were motivated by this field. We, in fact, this was run in cooperation with our colleagues from computer science. And this was run in a hotel Princesa Sofia. You can see it is advertised. So we were exploring different routes for, you can see here, Professor Mateo Valero, who is a member of the organizing committee. Just to round up 1992, we organized a conference in Chile. This was the first international conference that we did outside Barcelona. So we went to Chile, to Concepción, thanks to the good link with Professor Juan Carlos Heinrich. I haven't mentioned him. He was the co-editor of this journal on numerical methods in engineering in Spanish that I mentioned. So this was a successful event. About 250 people went there to Concepción, not to Santiago, thanks to the link with Juan Carlos. So this was the year also, 1992, where the CIMNE premises in the campus where I am sitting now, they were inaugurated. In fact, they were inaugurated after the Olympics. After the Olympics, there was a kind of Olympic depression. You know, everything really went down. The economy went down, but we were lucky that our building was finished and we could inaugurate the building. This is with the President Pujol and the members of the government. CIMNE was linked to three government department. This is territory and sustainability, I mean civil engineering. This was research and this was industry. This is our rector always there. This is still myself, you will not recognize me. And this is, we were very proud of these premises, as you know, that they it was a bit nice function. This was an extension of the buildings. It was not so easy really to add this kind of roof on the top. And of course, we had different celebrations. And Professor Sienkiewicz, who visited us those days, he also joined in one of the celebrations in the terrace together with Professor Jesús Carrera, who was the director of the School of Civil Engineering in those days. Now, I will jump some chronological order, not to make it so I would say linear, and I will talk about other premises that started a few years after that. CIMNE grew, and then we were needed more space, and we were invited to really join a joint venture with UPC and have two floors in a building here in by the sea, next to the beach. This is the beach, by the way, in Casteldefels, where many of you are working. You can see this is where we are. And these are very nice facilities. You know, I invite you to visit, with a nice terrace. You see, very modern. It was a big inauguration, and this is a reminder of those days that meant a lot for us because we could expand. And CIMNE has always been famous for the terraces. And following that trend, a few years later, in fact, some years later, we had the chance to build another building next door to us here in Barcelona, together with our colleagues from the Flumen Institute. And then we created a joint venture with them that I will refer briefly later. As this is more known to some of you, this is where many of you sit. And the top floor is for PhD students. And it's a floor that belongs to the School of Civil Engineering. And there are two floors for CIMNE, two floors for the Institute, Flumen Institute, and this floor where we have some 50 PhDs at the School of Civil Engineering studying. And we were expanding over the territory. We have a small office in Ibiza, but the largest other premises are in Madrid. And in Lake Lleida and Tarrasa, where the group for building an environment or the bioclimatic energies and work, but I still use the old name, building energy and environment, they work. And in fact, this is a picture that they sent me yesterday, the members of the group, some of the members of the group, that they split their activities between Tarrasa and Lleida, you know. So, and this is a picture that was provided by Fernando Salazar, Dr. Salazar. And this is interesting, for I'm sure you don't know this. This is the group of CIMNE in Madrid. You can see most of them are civil engineers, if not all. Well, Joaquín Artoga is a mechanical engineer to start. You can see here that they have recently incorporated some new researchers from Peru, Bolivia, and Natalia Silva from Colombia in the center of the picture. This is Fernando. And of course, he insisted when he sent me this picture that you are all welcome to visit them because they are in the heart of Madrid, near Castellana, but in the heart of the city center. Okay. And we were very ambitious those days. We thought we could really expand all over the world, and we did. And we created premises in Singapore and Beijing, and also in Washington. And these are the persons who actually took care of this. Sonia Sacristá was many years in charge of CIMNE in China. Manuel López, still in touch with us, a naval architect, was in charge of the CIMNE office in Singapore. He is standing with Dr. Pere Andreu Bach, currently a scientist in CIMNE. This is our man in Washington, still there. And Javier Piecese, who has recently retired from these activities, because we have opened a new office in Latin America, substituting this office in Santa Fe, and this is now in Salta. You can see here Salta. Salta is in the north of Argentina, close to the Andes mountain range, beautiful scene, 4,000 meters high. And there is where Professor Sergio Yer, who was a former professor here at UPC, and CIMNE for almost 25 years, he's gone back to Salta, and he's now created this new CIMNE Iber, from where we want to really push many activities in the region. Unfortunately, the COVID pandemic has really affected all these plans, but this is hopefully to be restarted very soon. So I thank him for his initiative. And of course, in those days, I'm talking about the early 2000s, we started this network of labs, joint labs. We have something like 30 of these joint labs all over the place in Spain and in Latin America. And the last one has been recently created in the School of Industrial Engineering in Madrid. And I will not talk too much about it. I will only put this picture talking about history, because this is the when we started with the first joint lab in the School of Naval Architecture, because this idea of the joint labs comes from the School of Naval Architecture in Madrid, where Julio García, former steel head of the Naval and Marine Group in CIMNE, has moved recently. So he's going to restart the activities with this field, in this field, from Madrid. So he is reinforcing the Madrid team. Okay, so this is the kind of historical picture. But many activities have actually happened since then. We had regular meetings of this joint lab network in Argentina, in Santa Fe, in Barcelona. You can visit in the webpage. It's quite amazing how these offices, these premises really would like to show what they're doing. Some of them are joining in this meeting. I have seen Mauricio Paul from the CIMNE joint lab, CIMNE classroom in El Salvador. Well, I invite you to really to look in this into detail, and we really would like to give them a push in the near month. Recently, there has been the first international conference of the CIMNE classrooms that was held online 2 weeks ago. And we had a very nice event, actually. In 2009, and this is going back to the sequence of time, we had a huge event in Barcelona, because the king's daughter was a kind of patronizing the CIMNE joint labs. Unfortunately, you know, the royal family in Spain diverted in different situations, and she had to really leave this task. But there was a big show in Barcelona. Look, you can see, and many rectors of the CIMNE joint labs came to Barcelona, invited by us, this was held at the School of Civil Engineering. We were working in working meetings, as you can see, very highly populated. So, I wanted to bring this memory back, because for that you are aware of the importance of this initiative and the importance to keep this heritage in the next coming years. More pictures of the meeting. And then I would like to make a special reference to Professor Sienkiewicz, because he died, I would say, after a visit to CIMNE. In fact, after he retired in the 1990s, he was a regular visitor to CIMNE. Okay. From Barcelona, he will travel everywhere. So this is his room with the suitcase, and this is how he will be always ready to go. He was really a personality. Wherever you went, if you will go with him to China, to Australia, or anywhere in the world, he was really the number one person in the field, and also a person very dear and very recognized by his personality. In fact, when he turned 70, actually, he died around, he was 80 something. We had a conference on his honor in campus. You can see here, this is 1991. This is even before 1992, so I'm going a bit back and forth in time. And this is the best members of our community who came to Barcelona. This is myself here, to really greet Professor Sienkiewicz on this occasion. And we published a book, and this was again in the School of Civil Engineering. This is Professor Samuelson, who was the president of the International Association for Computational Methods those days. And Professor Sienkiewicz later on had this award from CIMNE, and this was given in the third conference in 1996 in Zaragoza. And he was a kind of a source of inspiration and a source of attracting talented people into Barcelona. And we will meet with them, and then Barcelona and us, we will be known all over the world. This was 10 years later. 10 years later, we offered him in the Sienkiewicz room some little memento, and from there on, you know, he was accompanied by Professor Taylor, Professor Bob Taylor. This is a picture taken in CIMNE corridor. Professor Taylor, he's a co-author of Professor Sienkiewicz's book, a personality in the field of structural mechanics, a professor in Berkeley for over 45 years. Now he's retired, but for many years he was a kind of, I would like to say, a friend, an assistant. Assistant because Professor Zinkevet was losing sight. He could not see. So he was taking care of him, driving him home. Well, he was really, he did a great job, a humanitarian job with Professor Zinkevich. And this was soon before he died, because he died in 2009. And I bring this picture here with Professor Zinkevich and Sergio Edelson. Sergio took care of bringing Professor Zinkevich to Latin America a few times. And this is one of the last pictures of both of them lecturing. They were actually lecturing without any projection because Ole could not see. So they were talking and giving their impressions about present and past and future of finite elements. Okay, so they were actually talking to the audience. And this was a kind of a different type of lecture, but it was highly appreciated. So there was a lecture without any multimedia presentation. Okay, after he died, her wife, Helen, whom had accompanied him to Barcelona on many occasions, actually came, and we created the CIMNE, the Zinkevich Seminar Room at CIMNE. And this was 1 year after he died. He came with a daughter and husband, and this was the occasion where the seminar room was created. Time went by, conferences were held. CIMNE has organized more than 200 conferences on different fields. We were very motivated about education, as I mentioned, and we produced the release of a number of educational programs, which became a tradition. Now they are very much old-fashioned. You can see that they were even translated into four languages here, French, English, and German, and to teach finite elements and to teach structure, finite element analysis for structures, as you can see. So our teaching vocation was expressed in that way. That year, 1994, we created the Journal Archives of Computational Methods together with Professor Michael Kleiber, and was supported by Professor Zinkevich and Oden. This is still going. And COMPLAS went on and on. And in those days, this is a historical note, you can see that we were having the COMPLAS dinners at the government palace. We were having the COMPLAS dinner at the Salon, at the Generalitat of Catalunya. Now it's forbidden. Now this is impossible. I mean, in those days, for whatever reasons, we were given the permission to have a cocktail in a patio outside this San Jordi room, and their dinner actually in San Jordi room. And our colleagues from all over the world, they were amazed by this possibility. Anyway, a series of conferences on historical constructions and forming processes, etc., etc., went on and on. Of course, COMPLAS, and we are already in 1997. 1997 was the 10th anniversary of CIMNE. And again, you can see here that this is the San Jordi. This is, in fact, this is San Jordi and the Dragon. In the San Jordi room at the government palace, this is Professor Zinkevich. This is the Rector Ferraté. This was Professor Subirà, who was the president of CIMNE. And this was the Rector, Jaume Pallès. He was the director of UPC. Okay, so, and it was 1 year later when IACM awarded to us and our colleagues from Argentina, in fact, to them and to us, the organization of the fourth World Congress on Computational Mechanics in Buenos Aires. And of course, to put pictures here of this event would be too long. Let me tell you, it was a great success. We took about 1,500 people to Buenos Aires. In fact, they went there, and it was organized by Professor Edelson, and it was a great success. And this really put us in the forefront of the IACM. I was the president for a number of years. The current president is Antonio Huerta, whom I have seen at the beginning of this lecture. And this gave us tremendous visibility, because I had also chaired the European Association of Computational Methods. So I think CIMNE was at the top of the field in those days, supported by our many colleagues and friends. I think we have built a friendship with many of them. And in fact, these associations were kind enough to allow CIMNE to run the secretariat. So now, here from the Congress Bureau, we support the secretariat of the IACM and the Spanish Association and other organizations like this one recently created to support the CIMNE classrooms. It's called International Association of CIMNE Classrooms. Okay, so this was part of building an institutional flavor in CIMNE. Okay, we already in 1999, and then I bring this not to bore you with conferences, because that year the government gave us the highest award. Highest award in 1999. This is, you see, this is almost, this is quite a long time ago. This is 21 years ago, in fact, 22 years ago. Yes, this is the Narcisse of Montreal plaque. He was an inventor, Narcisse of Montreal, and this was offered to us in the Ritz Hotel in Barcelona, and this is part of the distinguished personalities, the president of CIMNE, the rector, and other politicians, and of course, Andreu Masculiel, who was the founder of the Research Center Network in Catalonia. So this is an important thing. And then ECOMAS was founded a few years later. This is the European Association of Computational Methods, and one of the conferences that they were running every 4 year intervals was organized in Barcelona, and this was held actually in the World Congress in the it's a building for world events, which was finished just a few weeks before the conference. This was one of the meetings at the CIMNE terrace of the presidents of the international associations in the field. You know, you can see that we were always around the good table. The year 2000, in fact, with the change of the century, we decided to explore other fields, and then we had this conference on social sciences. Well, this brought us to be in contact with people from psychology, from the field of the linguistics, of course, economics, and GIT started the series of conferences, and then we were pushing this international network of conferences, and we helped our colleagues from the US to know South America. For instance, this is Professor Owen, Professor Scheffler, Professor Belisco, Professor Hughes, and Professor Oden in Guanajuato, Mexico. Well, believe it or not, it was the first time that they went to South America. And they live in Texas, Professor Oden and Professor Hughes, you see. So anyway, we have tried to bridge this gap between the Americas and the North and Central and South America. And it was a very successful event and helped to create the Mexican Association for Numerical Methods and many other activities. Also, we supported a special event. 8 of our colleagues were turning 60 in 2002. Now they will turn 80. In 2022, okay? And we had the first meeting with them in Ibiza. You can see this was a very successful event. We repeated this in 2012 in Barcelona, which I don't have pictures of that. Moving on, in 2003 and 5 and 7 with Complas, again, Complas dinners in different places, and restaurants. You can see many pictures of the community. And Complas became, as I mentioned, famous for the social life, for the spirits of the conference, for the gatherings. Professor Owen and Professor Rigers and Professor Criswell. And you see, this is Professor Owen. He was happy that I showed this picture, because sometimes they came to the lectures after long nights. You can see here, and I dare to bring this just to give honoring Professor Owen, who has been, on top of being an honorary doctor from our university, to whom we propose, he has been a source of inspiration and support for many years. He died recently. He died last year. He was the chairman of the Scientific Council of CIMNE, together with Professor Manuel Castellero. You can see him there. And Professor Owen, you see, he was, well, always ready to put Barcelona in front of anything else. You know, I insisted, let's go to Swansea for the conference. No, he wanted to come here. And you see, he died early last year, you know. January 13th, 2020. So we'll have Complas on his honor, and we will remember his spirit and his humor and his support for many years. And it's very sad that this goes with time. Professor Castelleo, I'd like to show this picture of himself in Ibiza, where his wife is from. Summers, we used to meet there over relaxing dinners and beautiful spots. And he was not only the person who hired me, he was also one of the founders of CIMNE. You can see he was there at the UNESCO celebration. And he has been, despite that he has been away from Barcelona for over 25 years, in 1992, for almost 30 years, he has been very supportive to us. I would like to mention his name and acknowledge his support. Many other people who has, I just bring the important ones. Professor Tom Hughes was one of the presidents of IACM. Without him, I would not have actually had any chance of taking this job after him. He's very closely related to Professor Huerta as well. And he has been a supporter of us. And you can see him here with his wife and Professor Scheffler, Professor Idelson in one of the conference dinners. He enjoyed the Spanish Barcelona spirit. This is Professor Tom Hughes and his wife, Susan. And this is Professor Scheffler, together with Professor Idelson again in one of our reunions all over the place. I bring here this very nice picture, Professor Huerta, the current president of IACM, Professor Castelleo, whom I mentioned, Professor Manolis Papadrakakis, together with Professor Scheffler, here is the founder and organizer of the CAPEL conference. Next week we will have CAPEL conference online, but in 2 years' time we will go back to Greece for CAPEL, for the CAPEL conferences. Distinguished friends, Professor Jenki Jagawat, here is with his wife, and Professor Oliver, Javier Oliver. He was the president of IACM after my term, and also very supportive from Japan. You will not actually believe it, how much he has supported us. And from China, our contact was Professor Mingwu Juan. Mingwu Juan, who, you know, in China, seniority is a privilege. And they were both senior citizens, senior scientists that they have supported us. And this was during the World Congress in Beijing. You can see here behind the showroom that they was given at the banquet. So I have to move on. I would not like to waste any time of this. This was a kind of never-ending tradition, almost for 10 years. Every summer we will meet in the Rector House Gardens, together with our colleagues from different groups in CIMNE and also UPC. We will have an Argentinian grill that was managed and run by the Chief Gaucho Professor Idelson. He is with Professor Reinald Lerner, member of the scientific board of CIMNE, a current visitor. He will give even a lecture in 2 weeks' time. And this is how Professor Idelson, how Sergio will dress for the occasion. And he will feed with his team about 150 people. I used to say it was like a wedding. This is Professor Oyer, the founder of CIMNE Iber in South America. And we used to work, all of us. Here is Miguel Ángel Celigueta representing the young community in CIMNE, young at those days, young still, helping to create the scene and to wrap up the scene so that we could actually go back the next year. Moving on, 2005, and this is a couple conference. I mentioned Professor Manolis Papadrakakis. Here is with Professor Ram. And this is how this conference has become a tradition. Conference by the after dinner dances. You see, this is myself, joining the Sirtaki in one of the conferences. And you, if I tell you, don't miss it, the next conference in Greece when it happens. And then this went on, the conference. This one was in Ibiza in 2007. And in 2008, we had the World Congress of Computational Mechanics in Barcelona. This was a big event, in Venice, together with the ECOMAS conference. It was a huge event with 2,000 people. Moving on, conference on particles, COMPLAS. And then we are getting closer to our days. In 2012, after the initiative of Professor Joseph Dolph, who's now an honorary professor, we merged forces with Flumen. I already have mentioned this, and we have created this joint institute. Yeah? I don't have time to elaborate on that, but I think this has given them the opportunity to apply and to expand and contribute to this exciting world of river dynamics and hydraulic engineering, going back to the roots of our profession. But 2 years after that, in 2014, this was the height of the conference organization in CIMNE, because in Barcelona we had the joint World Congress together with the two conferences on computational mechanics and fluid mechanics of ECOMAS, and this was attended by close to over 4,000 people. Okay, you can see this is one of the there were three rooms like this one. You see, this is in the opening. This was in the Congress Hall nearby, and this was a big success to be remembered for many years, because it's going to be difficult to beat this kind of audience. Hopefully, we will go back to those days. And this is the organizers: Professor Huerta, Professor Oliver, Xavier Oliver, and myself with the organizing team. And Cristina Forace, she was the head of the CIMNE Congress Bureau those days. And well, we were here enjoying one moment during the reception, the first day, you know, after the starting of the conference. Okay, I skip a few things. Just to mention here that going back to this link with UPC, we have always been very close to UPC. We contributed to the many of the activities myself at the graduation day of the civil engineering community, together with my colleagues at the Department of Structural Analysis. We meet every year, and this is one of the meetings: Professor Huerta, Barbat, Oyer, Santiago Badia, Benjamin Suarez, Juan Miquel Canet, this is myself, this is Gabriel Bujeda, and this is Ricardo Rossi, and this is, I think, is Ramon Codina. So this is a fantastic that we have kept this tradition almost over 40 years getting together. Okay, and also the support of my colleagues at the School of Civil Engineering. This is only a few of the directors. It happened to be together one day and we took a picture. There are many directors missing. Antonio Huerta is missing, Professor Casas is missing, but I would like to bring here this acknowledgement to some of the directors of the School of Civil Engineering, some of them closer to the field, like Professor Carrera or even Professor Alonso, and others not so close to the numerical methods field, more experimentalists, like Professor Antonio Aguado, Professor Murcia, and Professor Antonio Marí, who is also a very fine structural analyst. Well, CIMNE social life, just a few glimpses. You see, it is already almost 10 years that we had the big outdoor event. Hopefully, maybe I would like that this will happen again next year. This is some spot pictures of the calçot, this outside outdoor dinner with these onions, long onions, and this is some pictures of, here is Anna Fon and some of our members of the staff. And this is how you eat calçots. And this is how you really help calçots to go in. Okay, we were very proud. We have collections, I think like 20 cups, because we have, we had two soccer teams. I haven't heard from them recently. I should find out what they're doing. And also we commemorated the 25th anniversary in 2012. This is 2 years after the calçot dinner. But then we went through a difficult time because of the crisis, and in 2017, this is coming now to modern times, we were lucky to, through the initiative of Mr. Ferran Falcó, who is here, and with the support of the CERCA, this is Luis Rovira, Ana Font, this is Luis Ramallo, the president of UNESCO, and this is the former president of CIMNE, Damien Calvet, we were invited to join again the Department of Public Work. For many years, this is where we started, I haven't said it, but for many years, we were affiliated to the Department of Research, within which we were more or less competing with another 40 centers. And our personality had been a bit diffuse. Now, in 2017, we recovered our affiliation with the School of Civil Engineering, with the Department of Civil Engineering. It was called, in those days, Territory and Sustainability. And this really meant a turning point for CIMNE in those days, really. And that same day, we were celebrating the 30th anniversary. It was already then when Mr. Ferran Falcó, who was the Secretary General, came during COMPLAS and say very nice words for CIMNE. And then he, not only words, he really pushed a number of initiatives. We merged an institute for innovation in transport within CIMNE. CIMNE is one of the now very active research groups. This was an institute that was belonging to the government earlier on and now is part of CIMNE. And then he helped us a lot to push what we call the transfer of knowledge to society, because he's the chair of this organization that takes care of this activity. Well, some of you have seen this, I don't need to repeat it. CIMNE is next to the university, but we want to push what we do in CIMNE towards the market, towards companies. And this has been a parallel activity to our research line. This is what we call the circle of ideas. In 2011, we created a company called CIMNE Technology. And this has really helped to really create all these companies that you see here. Some of them, most of them exist. Some of them have disappeared, a couple of them. And Ferran Falcó is the chair of the managing board of CIMNE Technologia. Okay. So I don't have time to talk today about CIMNE Technologia. I will say that this is very important activity of CIMNE for us who are engineers and who would like to see a successful story in the as an outcome of our research. Some of these companies deal with software, some other dealing with robotics or Internet of Things. Well, this is going, you can visit the webpage and see what these companies are doing. I will just mention two iconics, and I would like to finish in five minutes. Builder is a company dealing with bringing this dream, which is to have a huge hangar into reality. These hangars have 5 meters diameter tubes, and they have been spread all over the world. For instance, this one, I don't think the video is working, but you can see if I click here, how the video, you see how this is inflated. And this is the biggest hangar in the world with 8 meter diameter tubes. And it was set up only less than 2 years ago in Saudi Arabia, you see. So this is an activity that is emanating for our research on membrane structures, research, which is expressed also in a number of conferences that are regularly organized over the years. This technology is also emerging from this activity in the field of membranes, cables, and lightweight structures. And we have this combination of a slab, an inflatable beam at 200 millibars, and a cable underneath that creates this very high strength bridge sustaining 12 tons. This is 15 meters bridge, which is used for emergencies by the army. And now it's been actually acquired by the Japanese, and this is now in Japan. And recently we have actually finished the 30 meters span. So going back to engineering, going back to structures, emerging new materials with new design concepts. And this has actually sustained a payload of 20 tons, 30 tons of critical load, 20 tons payload. Okay, this was an idea that was brought to us by our dear colleague, Professor Ben Cropley, who died 2 years back. He was one of the most original persons in the world that I know. He's a German, and I have learned a lot from him. Here he is, and I would like to really add his name to this long list, or not so long list, of persons. Here is with Mr. Javier Marcipa, who is the director of CIMNE Technology. Well, how about the future? Well, the future, you know this sentence, is very common. Maybe some of you don't. But I would like to make predictions. And our future is based on our present a little bit, because we are committed. We are committed by what we promised to do in this Severo Ochoa, this award, which is one of the most prestigious awards in Spain, and we got it a couple of years ago. And we were very happy to get it, as you can see when we learned that we got it, because we've been fighting for years to get it. And with this, we are in the top league of the scientific organizations in Spain. We celebrated that award. You can see a big event in 2019. This is Mr. Ferran Falcó here. But what the important thing is that we are committed, because we are committed to have leadership and impact at global level. Okay, and this is something easy to say, but we have expressed this in really writing. And we said that we are going to work in the next years to come to develop conceptual and computational models to understand, predict, quantify, control and design engineering natural systems. Okay, so this is a challenge, and with this message is how we got this award. And in fact, we have actually selected four areas where we would like to have high impact. One is, it's not in priority order. One is in the field of new materials with functional properties for engineering applications. The second is construction and transport for new, better buildings and better transport infrastructure and vehicles. Now, to help to a more competitive industrial sector, and then to help our planet to be environmentally friendly and safer. Okay, this was, we elaborated on these concepts in our proposal. We got it. We said that we would like to really have an holistic view of what we do in CIMNE. We would like to not only do computations, but to link the world of data and the work of devices and experiments all together to solve problems. And we got this award. And this has been expressed in the organization of CIMNE now. So what you see now in the web is not really outcome of only of our imagination. It's our commitment. We are committed to work in a number of, these are 23 areas, 23 research groups, research topics. Within these six areas, one is civil and environmental. The second is materials, as you can see. There is one on processes and mechanics, one on transport. And then it's a transverse area on innovative algorithms and high-performance computing techniques. And this is the expression of our commitment with this Severo Ochoa Award for the next years to come, at least up to 2023. But we would like this to be go beyond that. We have created a new area to support innovation and transfer. This includes development of tools like GID and other very important digital technologies. This is a very important group. And this is what makes CIMNE of today, but I think it will make CIMNE of the future. We have created a new managing team. I think you know all of them, maybe you don't. These are the faces. And I put here the faces of Ana, of Professor Diez, Fernando Salazar, and Professor Bujeda. And I mentioned here Javier, who works together with Ferran Falcó in CIMNE technology, closely related to CIMNE, very important. I always say that we have to produce paper and they have to produce financial revenues to CIMNE, and this is the mission. Okay, and talking about production, yes, these are recent figures, but this is our commitment. You see, we are incorporated in CIMNE 60 new researchers between 20 and 21. This is what we have already incorporated in 2020, 33. You can see here the men, women, in the total of PhDs, MSCs, research engineers, postdocs, 23. And now we are calling for 22 new PhDs. They have been selected and they will have to start in September, and 5 postdocs. So this is what this award has brought to us. We have incorporated 60 new persons and there will be another 15 more in the two coming years. So this is a tremendous growth in CIMNE. We are already 261 persons. Up to date, so I think that by the end of the program we will reach about 300 something. Many of these are temporary positions, of course. To sustain these large structures will be very difficult, but not impossible, because well, this is our challenge. I'm not talking about money today. CIMNE is sustained today mostly out of its own resources. About 85% of our expenditure comes from our own resources, which is a challenge, but this should be the subject of another talk. But you can see here the challenge of this. And this is the 21 affiliated scientists from UPC. I am one of them. I am an affiliated scientist from UPC. And this is why this is very important, that that this is a success story. And this is why Gabriel Bujeda is in charge of these institutional relations with the government and with UPC and other universities, like University of Madrid, with whom we have now a number of joint labs. Okay, but you see, I'm not talking about papers today, but you see, in 220, together with all this long story already, we published 120 papers. 120 papers that carry the name of CIMNE. Well, I think this is quite challenging. Our commitment was about 890. We did 110. And what is required, at least to be in this top league, that 75% should be in top journals. But we have an 80%, 82% in top journals. And this is our CIMNE age index, you see, which is, well, some of you know what it is, look at it in the web, is 131, which is not bad. This is the Google Scholar, of course. But you see, and we have something like 81,000 citations altogether for CIMNE together. Okay, and one of the journals that we publish is the number one in the world, which impact factor 7, is Archives. I mentioned it already started in 1995. And the starting journals, should be 1985, is still running, and we run it for UPC. We did 13 PhDs in 2020, not bad. Okay. We had many awardees, some of them are listed here, not all, I'm missing some of them. Okay, we give seminars, courses, coffee talks, we organize conferences. This you know, because you can see the webpage, we have something like 15 conferences to be organized in the next coming years. These are the list of the conferences. And I would like to finish, this is really the end, with an example of one holistic activity. I mentioned this link of computations, data and devices to help society, to help companies. And we have a project running, which is sponsored by the government, which aims to integrate numerical methods and digital technologies to support the management of transport and mobility and the maintenance of infrastructure and services to citizens, administrations, and industry. This might be a project for the next 20 years in CIMNE. Now, well, these are some of the applications. I don't want to read them all. It goes from evaluation of risk of different kinds to design of emergency situation, planning of infrastructures. So this is bringing predictive methods together with the core of civil engineering, which is planning infrastructures, planning territory activities, logistics, and including, of course, transport and mobility. And this was the starting pictures, data from satellites, data from social and economics and environment, tools to store the information using geographic information system, building integration modeling, GID and computing, decision support systems. What is amazing, I am very happy, is that the government has actually really taken this within themselves, and they are translating this into this. I don't want to read it. This is a translation in their own words. They call it blue box, green box, and this has been actually written by the government, and there are about 70 researchers, 70 involved in this project, which has this funny name that should be changed sooner than later. But anyway, I wouldn't need to mention this. And these are some snapshots of the platform that we are building here in CIMNE. And you see, this is a tremendous amount of work. This is managed by Dr. Javier Mora, mainly with support of Per Andreu Bach and many groups of CIMNE working in that. Now, this is the end. What I can promise you is that there is a future for numerical methods, but probably not this one. I don't think that you want to be in this position. I'd rather see you more like orchestrating and organizing how the tools that we develop, the methods, the models, the mathematics, and the numbers that we produce will help society, will help to make a better world. And with that, I want to thank you all. Sorry for being a bit late. Many thanks to all of you and all the persons that have who have helped CIMNE to become, I think, to become a center of reference in the field of computational engineering in the world. Many thanks. Thank you. Muchas gracias.
Thank you, Eugenio. That was a very entertaining and interesting presentation. I don't know if any of the 100 people that we have here have any comment or suggestion or maybe any idea. or just want to say something.
I can see Jordi Cipriano is laughing. Ladies laughing. Did you recognize yourself, Jordi, in that picture?
No, not really, not really. We were very young. Yeah.
So I want to thank those of you who have actually joined from very far away. I have seen Mauricio Paul from Salvador. I have seen Alex Lotepegui from Argentina. Also Norberto Nigro, at least, and many more, I think. Thank you. Oh, Farship also from Iran, from Tehran. Well, maybe I will have a look to the list. Now the next lecture will have to add something more new to what I have said today. Hopefully we will enter into more another type of anecdotes. There will be there are many other aspects of CIMNE, but thank you very much, Alejandro, for this nice opportunity.
No,
as Sados may come back, this is a message for Professor Idelson. Unfortunately, I don't think the Rector House will be available to us, but we can find another location, you know. We could hire, I don't know.
Eugenio, can I say something about birthdays? Because I don't know if the others are aware, but this year the Building Energy Environment Group achieves 20 years of existence. But also, if I'm not wrong, the TIC group is also reaching 10 years. And one of the startup companies, Energy, is also celebrating 10 years of existence. So this year is also a celebrating day, a year for some of our CIMNE units.
20 years of a big group, Jordi, 20 years.
Yes.
That means that you are 30 plus.
No, 30, not really.
Well, 30 plus.
plus, yes. Week plus.
I see Alex, Professor Barbak. Let me say, Alex, you were one of the first persons in this room today whom I met, I think, maybe with us, perhaps with Professor Suarez and Professor Juan Miquel Canet. We met in 1979, I think. Is that correct? Or 1980?
In 1979, it's true. Completely true. In autumn 1979.
you were working in the garden with a folder, looking at, with some papers, I remember, on dynamic analysis of water tanks.
Elevated water tanks, yeah.
And say, I want to talk to someone with knowledge on structural analysis, and I said, maybe I can help you.
yeah. 22 years, Eugenio. Don't say nothing more. 42 years.
Eugenio, I have a question for you. You have mentioned that you were hired by Professor Castellero, right? Can you explain a bit more in detail what was that process of hiring all these professors in the School of Civil Engineering with deep knowledge on numerical methods, and what was the role of Professor Castellero and also of Professor Torroja in that building of the School of Civil Engineering in Barcelona with this deep knowledge on numerical methods?
Well, very briefly, Professor Castellero invited me to apply. Okay, in fact, I was hired by the university, and there was a selection committee chaired by another professor of mathematics who has recently died a few years back, a civil engineer and a mathematician. I forgot his name now. Anyway, he was the chairman of the selection committee. So I applied And I was elected
like
by
dough,
this committee.
No, isn't it?
Who?
Dough?
No, dough.
Garballo.
Ah, yes.
Emilio Garballo.
So thank you, Antonio. Emilio Garballo. Dough gave a lecture on Gödel's theorem in one of the opening classes in the chapel in the Com. So basically, it was not it was a formal process. So I wrote to Manuel, said, look, Manuel, is there any chance? I'm finishing my PhD in February. Is there any possibility after? And then he said, yes, send an application. So I applied and I was selected. And I joined for the second semester. That's what I can tell you. I was not selected because of my knowledge on numerical methods. You know, I think they were hiring any academic with a PhD. You know, in fact, many other current lecturers at the school, they were hired in those days. You know, some of them were hired in those days.
Thank you.
Yes.
Mora is pointing out that this has been also 20 years of builder, compasses, and structuralia.
Yes, too many anniversaries, you know, too many anniversaries.
Many comments about the asados. Maybe we have to think about it.
Yeah, well, I think we should go back to this tradition of celebrating. We should have a kind of functions committee. Really, because everything needs to an organization, like what the job you are doing with this coffee talks or with Ignacy with the seminars. So maybe we should have a 35th anniversary committee that will go beyond that anniversary, because this function aspect, for instance, we are lacking a kind of a formal reception of our PhDs and postdocs. They are spread all over the place. So there is room for improvement. First, we need to. I have another presentation when I can say that CIMNE has also made progress after consolidating the development. So you reach a new plateau, you have to consolidate that, and then you need to. Now, producing 120 papers, 82% in QR, has been almost natural. In the past, we used to really twist arms and. Thank you, Antonio. Thank you very much. Thank you. And good luck, Antonio. See you soon. So, Sushi, consolidating equality level, I think, for me, is the key of development, you know? And this is what you see in developing countries, you know, that everything looks very easy, very normal, but it has taken years to really get. And we have to preserve it because it can be easily destroyed as well. So, but this is another talk. Alejandro, I'm going to drink some water, you know, because I forgot to bring a bottle of water next to me, you know. You can see I'm in my office. Yeah, Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you for your support.
Thank you, Eugenio.
If any of you would like to learn more, to have more details or anything, please write to me. I always try and intend to answer the emails. Thank you very much. Okay.
Okay. Thank you all.
Goodbye. Bye. Alex, thank you. Gerard, Javier, those of you, Jordi, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Sergio, thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Lucian, ciao, night.